The Millikan experiment, sometimes referred to as the oil droplet experiment, was conducted in 1910 by Robert Andrews Millikan and Harvey Fletcher. The experiment provided the important proof that the electric charge Q always occurs only in integer multiples of elementary charge E of the electron. Millikan was awarded the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1923 for this proof. The experimental setup consists of a plate capacitor with plate spacing D. The plate capacitor is located under a transparent plastic hood and is illuminated from the side. The area between the capacitor plates can be observed with a microscope. Using a hand pump, oil in the form of small droplets can be now pumped into the field between the two capacitor plates. When the oil is atomized, the drops are ionized due to friction or natural radioactive radiation. Depending on the charge, the rate of rise or fall of the charged oil droplets in the homogeneous electric field of the capacitor plates results from the combination of the acting forces: electrostatic force, gravity, buoyancy, and friction with the air. If no voltage U is applied to the capacitor, the droplets sink downwards due to gravity. By applying a voltage, it can be observed that depending on the particle observed and the voltage applied, the particles either move further downwards, more quickly, or more slowly, or more towards the upper capacitor plate. There are two methods for determining the electric charge of oil droplets. One is the levitation method. In this method, the electric field is adjusted so that the gravitational force on a selected droplet is just compensated. The droplet floats. On the other hand, there's a sink-rise method, which we use here. Here, the movement of a selected droplet is influenced by the electric field. First, a sufficiently high voltage U is applied to the capacitor. The droplet is accelerated upwards and quickly reaches a constant speed. The droplet is allowed to move upwards by 20 scale divisions of the scale visible in the microscope, and the time required for this is measured. Then the voltage is switched off. The droplet falls down in the gravitational field of the Earth and quickly reaches a constant speed again. We drop at 20 parts of the scale and measure the time required for this again. From the difference between the two times, the charge Q of the oil droplet can be determined. If oil droplet number I sinks downwards and the speed falls zinc, Stokes friction acts on it against the direction of movement and thus the gravitational force. F zinc equals 6 pi eta Re V zinc. Here, eta is the viscosity of the air. If, on the other hand, oil droplet number I rises, the frictional force again acts on the opposite direction of movement, i.e. this time of the direction of the gravitational force. F steig equals minus 6 pi eta Ri F steig. The difference between these two forces is just equal to the force of the electric field. Fe equals qi times E equals qi times U over D. Droplet number I fields, it follows qi times E equals F zinc minus F steig. Qi times U over D equals 6 pi eta Ri V zinc plus V steig. Qi equals 6 pi eta Ri times V zinc plus V steig times D over U equals N times E, where N is an integer. The radius of particle I can be calculated by equating its weight force and Stokes friction in the sinking case. Mg equals 4 over 3 times pi times Ri to the 3 rho Öl minus rho Luft times G equals 6 pi eta Ri V zinc. Ri equals the square root of 9 eta V zinc divided by 2 delta rho times G. The density rho of oil and air is taken into account for the gravitational force and buoyancy. If the measurement is repeated several times, the distribution of positive and negative integer multiples of the elementary charge E is obtained. Electric charges occur as integer multiples of the elementary charge E. The value measured by us is compatible with the literature value of E equals 1.6021917 × 10⁻⁻⁹ Coulomb.